Congratulations to Tony. Thank you to Sarah and Emily who took part too. A massive win for Dad. And a little reminder, Sally Traffic did want that as a win too. It's not fixed though, I can promise you that. We do have witnesses and that is me. If you would like to play Family 3 tunes as well and you've enjoyed that this morning, why don't you send me a little message right now? Tell me who you want to play with. You can text 88291 or you can WhatsApp 08000 288291. But just before that, we had a text about a hot not date from a text messenger who didn't give their name, but we know their number, but also to Julie W, who was driving to meet them. And Sally and I wondered how they were going to get on. They've texted back in. Oh, thank you so much. She heard, that's lovely, Julie W. She pulled over and you might be helping our magic happen. And she goes, still listening to Radio 2 then. Oh my goodness, I'm sweating. I can't believe our cover may be blown, with lots of laughing emojis. Wishing you both all the best with this first proper date.
Is a sign of a good time.
Do you need help perfecting your beef Wellington, or are you on the hunt for the ultimate hot sauce recipe?
So you get a sourness, you get a heat, you get sweet, you get hot, you get everything. Reduce it down, then add a little more rum at the end.
Fear not, for my hungry panel are here to devour your questions, offer up inspiration, and dish out some advice of their own.
The back of the plane is more enjoyable.
Kent, I'm Sharon Terry. The head of South East Water has told BBC Radio Kent the company were caught on the hop by the speed of climate change. They're being investigated by the industry watchdog over supply issues which affected parts of Kent last summer. CEO David Hinton says more of us working from home was also a factor in increased demand.
It's linked into why that demand was high, and we all know we've had exceptional weather. That's the main driver, but we're also seeing changes in following COVID and the pandemic. We're seeing people having different lifestyle changes. Metre towns have definitely got effectively more people in them during the week than they had before, because people aren't travelling to London as much. We don't have the benefit of effectively now transferring water from London back where they used to use it. We suddenly supply them when they're at home.
Police are investigating the discovery of a body in the River Thames off Gravesend. They were called yesterday lunchtime to the pier area in the town. Ambulance, Coast Guard and lifeboat crews were still there several hours later. A village pub in Smarden, owned by the wife of celebrity chef Paul Hollywood, has been given planning permission to be converted into a home. The proposal to convert the Chequers has angered locals who want to buy the venue and run it as a community pub. Melissa Hollywood says the family-run business has been losing money. The pub was first on the market in 2020, and now any new owner would have the option to turn it into a residential property. The Bake Off star says his wife has experienced unacceptable abuse.
At the end of the day, the family want to sell the pub as a pub. They're not changing it into a house, they're keeping it as a pub. Whoever buys it can do what they want, knowing that they have a safety net of the fact that they can turn it to residential and do whatever they want to do with it. But the vindictiveness from the locals towards the family who have been here 18 years is unforgivable.
Police are investigating a potential stabbing in Swanscombe this week. Officers were called to London Road on Wednesday lunchtime, where two men were found injured, one seriously, and were taken to hospital. A machete was found at the scene. Two men were arrested and taken into police custody. A third man and a woman have been bailed. Ebbsfleet United manager Danny Searle says he'll pick the players who responded positively to last week's heavy defeat. The Fleet were beaten 5-1 by Gateshead in their National League opener. They host one of the favourites for the title, Barnet, this afternoon.
I can always allow players mistakes, and I can...